Georgian special forces have taken hold of villages scattered throughout Azerbaijan. Incredibly, Kombane Nugalads appears to have been able to move thousands of troops across the border over a course of weeks, completely hidden from both local and international authorities through a high-tech... Number of Azerbaijani casualties are unknown, but early estimates number in the high...
The freedom-loving people of the world cannot stand idly by and allow an act of such staggering inhumanity and scale.
In their third day of fighting, U.S.-led NATO troops took three more Azerbaijani villages occupied by Georgian special forces. U.S. troops met only light resistance and suffered minimal casualties. The Georgian commando cells are becoming increasingly hard to locate as military intelligence suffers repeated... Kombane Nugalads has vanished, along with his top military advisors. Speculation points to Nugalads' fear of a war crimes tribunal as motivation. A two-minute webcast from locations unknown, Georgian President Kombane Nugalads called America and its allies an army of scarecrows, declaring them helpless to defend themselves or their homeland. The precise nature of Nicolaz's threat, experts fear, could make itself known within...
GF for Aldrich, Georgian waters, Caspian Sea, October 27, 2004, 09:38 hours. Retrieved Georgian communication data, NATO and US intervention has pushed most of the Georgian commandos from Azerbaijan, with only a few well-hidden cells remaining. One of those cells, entrenched in an oil rig on the Caspian Sea, is exchanging data with the presidential palace in Georgia via a secure network.
Fisher, we've uploaded your mission objectives. Grimstarter says the rig's encryption protocols are bulletproof, so we're going to have to let one of Nicolaz's geeks log on before we get a chance at any intelligence.
Why would they be holding onto this rig? It's not Nicolaz's smartest play.
That's what got our attention. Nicolaz is sacrificing several cells to hold onto it, so whatever's coming over the network must be critical. Mission objectives on your opsat.
So, greetings fellow things. Welcome back to some more Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell. This particular level is the oil refinery and it is exceedingly buggy. And, well, it's just the worst level in all of Splinter Cell history, just because of how buggy it is. You'll get to know what I'm talking about in a few. You want to keep on the wood here. You don't want to get stuck in that place there, get onto the pipes just yet, otherwise you'll not be able to climb up onto the woods. And already we're stuck. Got out by jumping. Oh, damn. Yep, and this is what I was talking about. Yeah, so let's hope that we don't end up... The ocean looks sort of wonky. Yeah, I'm just gonna quick save here, so that, you know, we don't end up bleaching out again. And so basically what we want to do here is, so as I was saying, this is a pretty action-packed level of Splinter Cell, and it's short, but there's a lot that could go wrong in this tiny time frame. There's practically no need to rush here, but it's eventful to say the least. And you might want to keep saving every now and then, because this is one of those levels where it literally wants to force you into a confrontation. And I think this is probably because of my third party.
Visual on hostile forces. We're blowing the bridge immediately. Repeat, blowing the bridge.
Yeah, so you don't need to worry about that. They did not see us. And like I said, this game is typically buggy, and it's, well, let's just say it's very buggy. So, especially on the PC version, you're gonna have to try a few times before you can actually get to that platform over there. And I'm just gonna quick save again here, because this is just one of those places where it can go bad. The sea is also looking square, probably because of my application, the party application which I used to enhance the graphics, called DG Voodoo 2. So, yeah, I guess, well, got to live with it.
I'm
doing wrong? What am I doing wrong? I mean, yeah, I did have troubles with it last time as well, but... finally got it. Hell. So, yeah.
Bad news, Fisher. Something got the military's attention.
Oh, boy.
You just got booked into the single digits on NATO's list. Find yourself in a position to get that data. Time just got scarce.
Yes, sirree. Yes, sirree. Anyway, moving on. Love it. And, well, let's hope that we can sort of, you know, let me just quick save here. Yeah. I didn't want to, we've got to drop down here. It took me ages to find it the first time around. There's a lot of smoke here, black fumes. You can turn on your night vision goggles, but yeah, they don't really
help. Everybody look lively. Our computer technician is returning with the encryption key. I need two men to meet him at the docking station and escort him to the data hub. Let's get this finished quickly. We're sitting dark out here.
And just look at this guy, walking like a gorilla. Well, finally. Managed to do it finally. Oh, you want to be stealthy here, not make too much noise. I don't know whether half of this level is the game acting up and just, you know, being all buggy. But, yeah, we can use either of these ladders. This one is a little better for our purposes. Here's the thing, you want to press the right button while you jump onto this platform, and you want to take it slow, not too quick. And those guys still have a chance of noticing you, so it's best if you don't rush into it, like I did. And, yeah, here is how we just shimmy along the pipes and just quick save here. Since everything seems to be going well currently, for the time being. And yeah.
Relay alert from Philip Mars. We have incoming American warplanes.
Actually, you can like you can get down from this, like, you don't need to constantly go like this. You can easily, yeah, what we want is for this guy to be under us while we drop down on him. And that's it. We do not want to hide his body or anything. And let me just make an actual save here. Not just a quick save, a proper save, because here's where things can start to get really messy. And one thing leads to another, and it's sort of a chain reaction, a slippery slope, if you will. So what we want to do is quickly head in here.
What the hell was that?
Let them go in.
That's our friends from the Air Force. Ground troops are imminent. We'll keep you updated.
Let's just quick save here. And we want this guy to go in as soon as it does. We'll try to follow.
We're under attack! He sustained heavy damage to...
Let's just see here.
American fighter planes! They're coming in again! Reports of incoming troop transport!
We want to get through here. Let's just stick here. And yeah.
Identify
we want to
yourself.
Be a little quick. Oh my god. Yeah.
We're under attack! We've sustained heavy damage to...
And let's just stick to this side here. We don't typically need to stick to the wall, but if we do its best. Let me just stick into this wall now. You don't want to be too fast or else...
American fighter planes! They're coming in again! Reports of incoming troop
quickly
transport!
Now. Yeah, and here I shall just make another save. Because, like you saw, things can turn real sour real quick here. And we just want to be a little careful in our dealings. Okay, this was a bad move, I guess. But okay, it wasn't. I suppose we can now come here. And let me just do. Oh my god! Okay, fine.
See? It's still spray!
I swear I turned it off!
Sure you did.
I did!
Let's hope You guys saw me save, didn't you? Oh well. I'll just count it as another one of the bugs of this game. Not too hasty now.
Won't pop it. I'm
working. Now we can go.
I did. I think it's broken. Hold on.
Now I gotta remember that. Yeah. That shift is the down button. And we just want to stick up here. I mean, I've never had a bug that's messing with my saves before.
Change of plans, Fisher. You're going after that technician building. You want to change
the downloaded the data for that.
To a laptop device. Use whatever force necessary.
I'm just going to quick save you once. Yeah, that did not. With all the bugs in the game, I'm now thankful that it did not crash the game either. Okay, fine, so it was a matter of speed, rather. So the first time around to play the game, I killed all these soldiers because, well, I sort of rage quit, if you will. I suppose this is the tool that I have to take. And this is the path that I have to take here. Although where I go from here, I've got no idea. Probably this way? Did I just run a full circle for no reason at all? Apparently I did. And there is Philippe Mas. And we have to run after him. But he's getting away. I wonder how we do that. This could not have gone any worse.
What makes this worth the risk?
Who the hell are you?
Don't ask any more questions. Answers only and fast.
I understand.
What's the data?
I'm just a messenger. I don't know. Something about an Ark.
What's that?
I don't know. What Nicolas wants most.
Where were you going to take the briefcase?
I don't know. I wasn't going to find out until I was on board the escape ship. Mas is a complete control freak.
Mas.
Please, I don't want to. Ah! Philip Mas, Nicolas's lead programmer. I swear that's all I know.
Okay. So what we want to take first is the brief satchel, because you will be reading it now. Huh. Oh, finally, there's level data as well now. I see. Oh, I guess that's what happened first. I wonder why I'm getting all of this data. Maybe the devs wanted us to blow things up here. Designed as a UFO reservoir for offshore drilling rigs. Following is a transcript of a fragment of a radio message intercepted by an SR-71 pilot and an AWACS AVAX. AVAX control aircraft over the Caspian Sea. AVAX. Any entrances to the hub? Assessment of static. Some kind of automated blaster. Static. Data hub. Appears to be one window into the hub. And intercept. Damage to the cylinder shell can cause massive leakage. Piotr Levaya. Lejava or Lejava? I don't know how you say that. Then get another job. Think it'll do any good without the key. I'll get whatever I can, but I really think Nicholas will need men inside the presidential palace, which is obviously impossible considering the current state of affairs. But I will do my best, and whatever is possible to retrieve from the oil rig, I'll get it. Piotr. I've heard Piotr means dick in Russian. I wonder if that's true. I'm just going to save this under oil rig again. Sorry, oil refinery. Yes, please. And I'm going to take up the beat piece.
Great job, Fisher. Time to make yourself scarce.
Boy, that was some buggy level. GFO Ulrich, Georgian waters, Caspian Sea. October 27th, 2004, 10:21 hours. I don't know, for some reason the sunlight and everything looked like it was already sunset, but okay, if you say so. Communication data retrieved from the Ulrich has proved to be invaluable. The records are full of vague hints concerning an impending retaliation against the US, More concretely, they show evidence of a leak in the US intelligence community suggesting that the Georgians may have a mole inside one of America's agencies. And so basically the data that we picked up, that Sam picked up here, sort of led us to believe that it, as you can read here, that the intelligence, like Nicoladze has been gaining intelligence from one of our, not our, the US's own agencies. And so basically the next step is to determine where the leak came from. As far as this level was concerned, it was stressful to an extent, and not the kind of stressful, you know, which you experience when you're playing a good stealth action game. This level was more the kind of stressful where you have to keep reloading every time and again simply because of the bugs that you encounter. And the first time around I played it, I killed everyone, I took more time, yet for some reason it always went much smoother than it did this time. And I basically rage quit the first time around, but rage quit as in rage quit stealthing, because you know stealth is optional for this mission. But what do you call it? So, I mean, I could catch the computer technician in his tracks before he reached the pier, and this time it seems going stealthy was the slower option, even though I literally whisked through the entire game, through this entire level actually. But it is what it is, but one of the good things about this game is how it shows me places where I might want to go. So I now know that Georgia and Azerbaijan are two different countries that are actually on the map. I didn't know that before. It's how little you know of these Slavic countries, but hey, of Eastern Europe in general. But it's good. It's a good thing. Now onto the next level.